Please stand. Welcome to St. Dominic's Church for this celebration of the Eucharist. This weekend we are celebrating the 27th Sunday in Ordinary Time.
Everybody to St. Dominic's Parish, especially those who are visiting us, guests, you are welcome. This is your spiritual home. Let us begin this Eucharistic celebration. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. This Holy Mass is offered for the repose of the soul of Tony Alves and all the deceased members of his Alves family. Remember him and all the deceased members of his family in a special way during this Mass, along with his family members gathered here. May Almighty God, the good Lord, grant his soul and all the deceased members' soul eternal rest. May their souls rest in peace.
Amen.
Today we specially pray for all the married couple, all those who are blessed as being good couple, good husband and wife, and all those people who are going through difficult times in their marriages, and all those who are intending to marry this year and in near future. Let us acknowledge our sins and seek God's mercy and forgiveness so that we may become worthy to stand before his presence. Lord Jesus, Son of the Father's love, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, Friend of sinners, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, Model of those who love, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of
God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who in the abundance of your kindness surpass the merits and the desires of those who entreat you, pour out your mercy upon us to pardon what conscience dreads and to give what prayer does not dare to ask, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord God formed man from the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life and put him in the Garden of Eden to till it and keep it. Then the Lord God said, "It is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helper as his partner." So out of the ground, the Lord God formed every animal of the field and every bird of the air and brought them to the man to see what he would call them. And whatever the man called every living creature, that was its name. The man gave names to all cattle, and to birds of the air, and to every animal of the field. But for the man, there was not found a helper as his partner. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and he slept. Then he took one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into a woman and brought her to the man. Then the man said, "This at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of man this one was taken. Therefore, a man leaves his father and his mother and clings to his wife, and they become one flesh." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May the Lord bless us all the days of our lives. May the Lord bless us all the days of our lives. Oh, blessed are you who fear the Lord and walk in his way. By the labor of your hands you shall eat. You will be happy and prosper. May the Lord bless us all the days of our lives. The wife like a fruitful vine in the heart of the children like shoots of the olive around the table. May the Lord bless us all the days of our lives. In thee thus shall be blessed those who fear the May the Lord bless you from Zion in a happy Jerusalem all the days of your life. May the Lord bless us all the days of our lives.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. We do indeed see Jesus, who for a little while was made lower than the angels, now crowned with glory and honor because of the suffering of death, so that by the grace of God he might taste death for everyone. It was fitting that God, for whom and through whom all things exist, in bringing many sons and daughters to glory, should make the pioneer of their salvation perfect through sufferings. For the one who sanctifies and those who are sanctified are all from one. For this reason, he is not ashamed to call them brothers and sisters. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Perfect love. Alleluia.
be with you.
Your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Some Pharisees came and to test Jesus they asked, "Is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife?" Jesus answered them, "What did Moses command you?" They said, "Moses allowed a man to write a certificate of dismissal and to divorce her." But Jesus said to them, "Because of your hardness of heart, he wrote this commandment for you. But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate." Then in the house the disciples asked him again about this matter. Jesus said to them, "Whoever divorces his wife and marries another commits adultery against her. And if she divorces her husband and marries another, she commits adultery." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
God has joined us to one another and to himself. Catholic Church sees marriage as a covenant between a man and a woman who enter a partnership for the whole of their lives. It's a lifetime project. It's a lifetime project. A vocation that they receive, the grace of a special sacrament to make it viable, the sacrament of matrimony. You see, they receive the special grace, the sacrament of matrimony, to make it viable. Brothers and sisters, we have our parents, our siblings, our relatives who are married, and we have seen the marriage life. We have witnessed many ups and downs in their married life. You know, for a marriage to succeed requires a constant effort of goodwill to cooperate with the grace of God. That is why I said marriage. In marriage, we receive a special grace in the sacrament of matrimony. So for a marriage to succeed requires a constant effort of goodwill to cooperate with the grace of God. You see, a husband and wife, a couple, must always foster a relationship that is dynamic, never static. Living in married love with another person means dying to self in many little ways. Husband and wife, you know it. There's a lot of adjustment we have to make. Lot of room you have to make for each other, understanding each other, tolerating each other, putting up with each other, differences of opinion, temperament, moods. That is why I said living in married love with another person means dying to self in many little ways. For love is that kind of laying down of life for one's friend. Yes. While in the modern society,
While the modern society makes us tolerant of divorce following from marital breakdown, you see? But Jesus in today's gospel invites us to reflect on the ideal of permanence of marriage. And on the value of lifelong commitment. His words on the value of indissolubility, you know, set an ideal that is especially very difficult in our times. Yes, his words on the indissolubility of marriage set an ideal that is especially difficult for our times because we are so much influenced by libertarian ideology. You see, where the personal satisfaction, the libertarian ideology always encourages where a man or woman, where a human being pays attention to personal fulfillment above all else. Brothers and sisters, for those families who have kept fidelity over the years, demonstrate that love can weather all the storms. Those who kept up the fidelity over the years, those families who are living examples, they demonstrate that love can weather all the storms, which even the best of relationships cannot always avoid. But instability of family life today and the large number of marital separations that needs to be prayed about. Yes, it's very, very sad. Today in the modern world, when we see all that is happening, how many, as a consequence of marital breakdown, the impact on the children and the, you know, large family member, it is very disgusting to see, disappointing to see. But at the same time, brothers and sisters, as Pope Francis has said so warmly, our church should show due regard for all people who are in new union. After their first marriage has broken up, again he says, for a grave reason, not just for silly reasons. You break up your marriage and get united with another one. No, for grave, serious reasons, he says. There are many reasons a marriage might fail. Possibly the married couple, possibly the parties were not emotionally matured at the time they married, nor fully free in giving their marital consent. And people who never thought the deeper spiritual meaning of their marriage can come to feel that their marriage was an unfortunate mistake. We know from our experience, brothers and sisters, yeah, we know it by our experiences, that not all the marriages reflect the ideal Jesus has set in today's gospel. You and I have, many of us will have relatives whose marriages have not lasted. Yes, and the Gospels are all clear. Although Jesus has a vision for human relationship, including within marriage, he did not condemn those who fall short of that vision. Brothers and sisters, on this day, as we reflect on the marriage, you know, as we bring before all the married couples, as I said right at the beginning of the Mass, we need to pray. Pray for all the married couples, those who are happy, those who are not happy, and those who are going through difficult times in their marriages due to various reasons. We need to pray for them every day. We need to pray for our own spouses. each and every moment, brothers and sisters. And at the same time, we know whether we are married or single, we have to love one another as God has loved us. Today, we pray, brothers and sisters, for all those couples, those who are going through difficult times in their marriages. May God give them the grace, strength, and wisdom to move forward, to find peace in their homes. And also those who are intending to marry, to be united in this sacrament, through the grace of God, they may find fulfillment in the love they profess. As we are in the month of October, month is dedicated to Our Lady of Rosary, month of Rosary. I bring before all the couples and all those who are going through difficult times and all those who are intending to get married, I bring before the feet of our Blessed Mother, Mama Mary, and ask her to intercede for all of you, all the couples all over the world, including all the couples of our faith community, St. Dominic's Parish, so that she may lift us up to the feet of our Lord and Savior, who can mend everything that goes bad or wrong. And with his divine love and mercy and compassion, he can straighten off everything. May, through the intercession of Blessed Mother, may God bless all our married couples and all those who are going through difficult times and all those who are intending to marry, so that we may always find joy and peace in living the love that has been poured out in our hearts and minds by Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Couples, please stand. Only couples, I would invite you to stand. We'll say a short prayer, and I would sprinkle holy water over you. Then we'll proceed with the Mass, okay? Don't feel bad. Don't hesitate. God is blessing us in a special way. Let us take this opportunity to thank and praise God.
Those who are sitting, pray for these beautiful couple. These are our parents, these are brothers and sisters, and all those who are going to marry, and all those who are going through difficult times in their marriages. Close your eyes for a moment, dear couples, as we implore the Holy Spirit upon you. Blessed are you, Lord, King of all creation. You have made us your beloved people and have showered your gifts upon us. I bring before you all these your beloved sons and daughters. We bless you and thank you for their years together. Continue to fill their hearts with love for you and for each other. Stretch out your hand upon them and bless them. Grant that as they have lived their lives with one heart and one mind, they may continue to witness to your presence in their marriage. Bless their children, all their relatives, and their friends, and lead them through this life to eternal happiness with you. We offer you all praise and glory through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us now place before the Lord our prayers and petitions. Kindly stand. Sorry, we'll profess our faith first. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Jesus said, "Let the little children come unto me." As children of God, we now turn to the Father with our prayers. Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church, that in her preaching and her actions, she may be a faithful bride to Christ, who renews all humanity in love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
As our country reflected on September 30th, on National Day of Truth and Reconciliation, we pray for the children who died in residential schools throughout Canada, survivors, and all those who continue to experience intergenerational trauma. May we continue the journey of healing and reconciliation in dialogue, partnership, and peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For married people everywhere, and for those experiencing tension in their marriage, that the Lord will bring them to a place of understanding, respect, and love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sons and daughters of God who were confirmed last month by the gift of the Holy Spirit, that they may always give witness to Christ by their lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and those who suffer in any way, especially those whose names are placed on our altar, that they may be comforted by the Holy Spirit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased loved ones, especially Tony Alves, Nicola Chicoria, Mia Furcal, Claudia DiCicco, Terry Charchalis, Elsa Bertola, Theresa Joseph, Tony Min, John Carlos Oliveira, that they may be welcomed into the eternal joy of the heavenly kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Pray in silence now for our personal intentions. Merciful Father, fill us with your Holy Spirit, that we may always give you thanks and praise. We make these prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen. When love is found,
that love may to reach beyond homes worn and light to strive and care for truth and brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
Glory of the sacrifice at your hand.
For the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifice. sacrifices instituted by your commands, and through the sacred mysteries, which we celebrate with a dutiful service, graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for through his Paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful gifts. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna.
Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness, make holy. Therefore, these gifts we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins." Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Thomas our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Dominic, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we now dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity. In accordance to your will live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us now offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Thank you.
We are one body in this world.
Let us pray. Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacrament which we have received, so as to be transformed into what we consume, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us on the day of our battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And to thou, Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Pray to Saint Joseph. To you, O blessed Joseph, do we come in our afflictions, and having implored the help of your most holy spouse, we confidently invoke your patronage also. Through that charity which bound you to the Immaculate Virgin Mother of God, and through the paternal love with which you embrace the child Jesus, we humbly beg you graciously to regard the inheritance which Jesus Christ has purchased by his blood, and with your power and strength to aid us in our necessities. O most watchful guardian of the Holy Family, defend the chosen children of Jesus Christ. O most loving Father, ward off from us every contagion of error and corrupting influence. O our most mighty protector, be kind to us, and from heaven assist us in our struggle with the power of darkness. As once rescued the child Jesus from deadly peril, so now protect God's holy Church from the snares of the enemy and from all adversity. Shield too each one of us by your constant protection, so that supported by your example and your aid, we may be able to live piously, to die in holiness, and to obtain eternal happiness in heaven. Amen. Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Thanks for coming out. As you know, we are done with First Holy Communions and Confirmations. I need to acknowledge many people, those who have been a great support for me during this last month. It's not easy. For 2 years, all those confirmation candidates and the First Holy Communions, baptisms, a lot. But by the grace of God, we were able to do that. And I really appreciate the help of you all, especially our ushers, Sergio, George, Gary, Gibson, Thomas, Edmund, who have been always there before time 6:10 to see the discipline and everything. They were there, present, welcoming the parents, the candidates, and everybody. Thank you, dear ushers, for all your great support. Also, our musicians, Sean Bater and Brian Bonici, for providing us beautiful music and making it more lively, more vibrant. Also, our acolyte, altar server Farrell, was always there. Even though he was going to school, he was there for the mass, helping me out, assisting with various things. Thank you, Farrell. And also our Eucharistic ministers, Freddie, Larissa, and Doris Zamit. Thank you for all your support and help. Also, our catechist, Beverly O'Grady, our parish secretary, Gloria, and our custodian caretaker, Michael, and also all the parents, all the sponsors, family members, and all parishioners for your prayers and for your support. I am ever indebted to you, grateful to you. And also, I thank especially Jesus and Mama Mary. New confirmation, new Holy Communion registration will start soon. As we are done with this one, we are starting, and dates will be announced by this week, next week, or following week. Thank you once again for all that you do, and especially your generous support. Thank you, thank you, thank you. We congratulate all these, our couple, whom we prayed for, and those who are, doing a great job being parents to their children, and being a best husband and wives. Let us give them a big round of applause. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
I will soar with you.